chose to join the Navy instead and has been replaced by John McCrae, a milkman. Rod Smart, at 21, is the youngest, an ordinary airman who wants to be an officer. He got through on a low mark, but Big and Hill were impressed by his determination to rise from the ranks. There are lingering doubts, however, about his ability to command. September 1978. The officer training unit at RAF Henlow in Bedfordshire. 86 cadets arrive. Most of them want to be pilots, but they'll have to be made into officers first. 50 of this lot want to join the elite and be fighter pilots. For the few who'll get there, it's a journey that will take 3 years. This is the first stage. 18 weeks of intensive training. The toughening up process.
Well, all I've got is 11 and a half.
They'll be a wee bit too young.
Well, if you get them in hot water and shrink them, they'll be all right.
They won't know until the last week of this course whether they're the staff officers are made of or not.
When you're brought to attention inside a room, you merely sit up straight. Got that? None of this standing up, otherwise we get scraping the chairs on the floor, noise echoing throughout the whole building. Don't forget there are other squadrons, other people working in here. So that's the first lesson learned. Take note. Now you've probably seen me around a bit of the time today. Now is the chance that I get to formally introduce myself. My name is Sergeant James. I am a member of the RAF Regiment, and I am here as your squadron senior NCO. My responsibilities, first of all, are for the general discipline. In other words, keep you lot in line. I'll stand for no nonsense. Don't try me. Get that in straight away. Drill and ceremonial is another of my responsibilities. Whilst we're on the subject, the boots that you have been issued, or conversely have not been issued, one or two of you, are very quiet, soft, hush puppy type things. We need to make noise when we're on the parade square. We can achieve that by putting Blakey's in our boots. A lot of people have talked to me asking about the barbers. The good book says the hair of the head will be neatly cut and trimmed. My interpretation of that is short back and sides. You are here to show us what you can offer. 100% effort is all we ask, nothing more, certainly nothing less. And what I've said, you play ball with me, I'll play ball with you. Just remember, it's my ball. Right, when I've left, you can get away and do whatever is necessary.
Attention.
In this first week, they'll meet their flight commanders, men like Flight Lieutenant Ollie Delaney. His job is to find out everything he can about the men in his charge, and it's important that they know about him.
Very shortly after I joined, the girl that used to do the milk round left, and I took over the milk round as well as, you know, working on the farm during the day. I didn't mind being a 22-year-old milkman, but not a 40-year-old milkman, you know, I just couldn't see that. And I realised that I had to do something, you know, pretty quickly.
Come on then, let's have some smiles. Look this way. Ready? Their initial worry is the newness of everything. Few of them are used to being away from home, that few of them are used to having to do things for themselves. Many of them have come direct here from school. They have no working experience and therefore little experience of dealing with other people. So their first reaction to the place is seen in the barrack block, for instance, in block 36. To be suddenly put into a room with five or six other people does come as a wee bit of a shock, and they have to learn just how to live together.
Rod Smart has already spent 5 years in the Air Force, but not as an officer. He was an airframe mechanic on Lightnings. Stepping up a class has put him under permanent scrutiny. He knows that his every act and every word are being judged. He's counting on his inside knowledge to carry him through.
Aged 21 years, 4 months, Smart is the younger child of a retired publican from Hereford. He attended Dunstable Grammar School from 69 to 74 and obtained 4 out of 8 O-levels in 73, and 4 out of 4 O-levels in 74. Smart is above average height... And
in a formal interview, you can prepare your case. An artfully contrived social encounter is another matter. Like this get-together for staff officers and cadets, officially called a meet-and-greet. The cadets know it, more cynically, as a meet-and-creep.
The reason I wanted to become a RAF officer is because, well, it's ambition, mainly, what I wanted to do. And I think better conditions all the way around. Everything sort of, you compare everything between sort of the airman side of life and the commission side of life. And the pros outweigh the cons by tenfold, I think. The airmen are looking up to you. You've got to set the example. You are, in fact, you become their leader. Instead of the led, you're the leader. Thing everyone, I think, strives for. You've got everything going for you on the commission side. After 16 years, when your time's up, when you don't sign on, so you can walk out, and the chance you can get a far better job because you've got that, the coveted Queen's Commission.
Once again, your damp cloth on the seam that you're going to press, using the hot iron, press down until you create the steam. And then, to dry off, use a piece of brown paper, old brown paper bag, anything like that, anything to keep the face of the iron off the trousers, prevents them going shiny. Sit up, you're going to sleep. Yes, you, second row. Once again, little job for this evening. Put on your boots, do them up tight, and stand in water. Over the top of your boots, doesn't matter if it comes up to your knees. But get the boots thoroughly soaked and then go off on a little walk. But half a mile, quite sufficient. You go to the barber's, did you, Mr. Smart?
Here, Sergeant, no.
Not here?
No, Sergeant. As I know,
go today.
Sergeant.
Look up! Your weight evenly distributed, shoulders square to front, stomachs in, chests out, chins back. turn the wrists in. One big fault, turn the wrists in so they're flat against the side of the body. Thumbs to the front, feel for the seam of the trousers with the thumbs of the hand. Remember, stand still, this is an alert position. You do not move and wobble about. This is where the self-discipline comes in. An alert position waiting for any other word of command. Up, turn! Turn! Come on, shout it out. I want you to wake all these people up here in the quarters that are lazing in the beds. Stand still. Stand at ice!
One!
Up, turn! Turn!
One!
What are you looking down for? You haven't got the coordination to know when your heels are together or not. You shouldn't be here. Right! Turn!
One, four, two.
Still! Don't twitch and wobble. Stand still. Where do you think you're going? You're not falling in, not without permission from me. Come here! Now then, Braden, where have you been? And?
I went there, they told me to report to parade at 10 o'clock. Went to the officer's mess, sat down, went to the loo, sat down, came back and happy now.
Feel okay now? Right, you'd never ever fall in without permission from the instructor on the parade ground. Got that? Fall in. One run! Aim out! Turn!
One, four, seven!
Right, aim. Left, right, left. You've got no brains! I can have you out here at 7 o'clock in the morning! Right, look at you! Whole squadron's out of step except you, lad! Sort it out!
The first thing that's thrown at you is, in my case, the inspection. I've actually been inspected, and meaning in charge of people that are being inspected. I was definitely quite nervous, and it was one of the first times that I was sort of put in actual charge of the guys in the room. If the inspection goes wrong, it's your neck that gets chopped.
Right, gentlemen, generally a better standard than last time, but keep on improving. I can still find dust, I can still find flecks on counterpanes. Remember, the purpose of all this is to teach you discipline and therefore your own self-discipline. So keep on improving. Thank you.
Just need leave your PT kit here. Go on the parade tour now. So you fall out downstairs.
To the straight side. Ring your hall. Outside, ring your hall, right?
No, at the block. The road between ring and hall.
Ready! loads, grouping, using the white aiming mark. In your own time. In your own time, go on.
I have no live rounds, missed fires, or empty cases in my possession, Sergeant.
I have no live rounds, missed fires, or empty cases in my possession, Sergeant.
For 5 weeks, they'll learn how to cope with gas and radiation hazards. Now they're sharply reminded that they're living in the age of nuclear, biological, and chemical warfare. The lectures range from civilian riot control to nuclear global strategy. They're even required to know the taste of CS gas.
Okay, you're in the contaminated atmosphere. Right. If you haven't got a way, come on, card. Right, quick, number, rank, and name, and I'll let you out.
P8027199,
Officer Cadet, McCurd, KD.
F8027173,
Officer Cadet,
Bellard, Sergeant. You have in front of you a table laid out... Nothing is left to chance, meals. Not even table manners. The war game becomes momentarily a finishing school for those who have to bridge that social gap.
Right, you've sat down to breakfast. The dreaded sauce. What about that?
Right.
Side of the plate. Mustard. On this side, what you would meet at a typical dining-in night, a four-course meal, and on this side, a seven-course meal. What is a rule of thumb if you sit down and you're faced with a mass of silver like that?
That's the idea.
We've all been reading the books, obviously. So how are we going to tackle these? You're presented with a banana, that's a banana, and an apple. How are we going to tackle them? Cut them. You would not normally get a banana, but an apple, cut them up, and eat them that way.
Well, I'm waiting, so we came up.
Catering.
The wine is well balanced, correct amount of fruit, and it weeps slowly and steadily down the grass. If, for instance, this...
You're going to eat something with it.
Yes, if, for instance, this had been a poor vintage, say a rather wet vintage, the wine's rather thin, there'd be a tendency for that to run down the side of the glass very much more quickly.
All right, we camouflage his face. Like that.
Smart is a very young 21-year-old. And it reflects in his performance. He's very, very apprehensive about being assessed. He's apprehensive in the face of authority. And the distinction is very clear, because if you can get him on his own, away from a formal situation, he comes across as a very different individual. But he may be someone who just might need time.
Come in.
Sit down, Smart.
Halfway through the training course, and the cadets are called in for a frank appraisal of their performance so far. This is a counselling session. Rod Smart isn't doing too well, and Ollie Delaney has 9 weeks left in which to sort him out.
What I want you to do in this is to tell me how you think you've got on, and then we'll link that to what I've written about you, and then we'll discuss the various points that arise, okay? So, what do you think is the key point of your performance on the course so far?
My confidence or lack of. Also, I think I need to be more forceful and decisive. My main problems at the moment, and also nerves. I think that stems from my underconfidence.
Okay, so how do you project as a leader?
I think I'm flustered under too much pressure. When things start going wrong, I start panicking. But if things are flowing quite smoothly, I think in most cases I'm all right there. I mean, the same with most people. Everything's running smoothly, they can cope quite successfully.
How do you feel you've developed during the first half of the course? Do you think you've improved?
Yes, I feel I've certainly improved.
What about, how do you think you're coming across as a personality within the group? You know, bearing in mind some of the comments that we said about you before.
I think I'm improving. I don't know, it's still the same, really. I've changed a lot. I think in the first few weeks, I'm still very quiet. But I have people get on top of me. And I think at one point I became a laughing stock, because I didn't fight back.
What's happening now?
I'm going to fight back.
Summary. Smart's progress has been slow but steady. The underlying factor governing his performance remains his underconfident, impulsive nature. He is clearly apprehensive in a formal assessment situation, as he is anxious to do well and is deeply disappointed by failure. Smart must learn to accept assessment, as you've had to do in the past, and you must solely concentrate on the task in hand. You must be prepared to be more forceful and authoritative, and exercise a control over events. Finally, he needs to be more circumspect in his approach to problems, and you must be careful of the image you project to others.
Come in. Please sit down.
Thank you, sir.
Relax, please. Can you give me your name, please?
Huh?
Your name?
David Llewellyn Jones.
And where are you from?
From North Wales, sir.
And whereabouts were you born in North Wales?
Crowside, Threegog, sir.
I see. Do your family still live there?
Yes, indeed, sir.
Are you from a very large family,
Well, I suppose there's my mother.
Rod Smart is struggling and knows it. But the rest of them aren't doing too badly. As the course nears its end, they're being prepared for the possible hazards ahead. Alistair Stewart is doing fine. He's rated a top contender for the Sword of Honour for the best all-round cadet.
Right. As you can see, we are on a shelter. There's another shelter over there.
Trevor Lewis is showing admirable stamina, but his report says he lacks verbal fluency.
And our mission is to get across from one shelter to the other.
Apparently you've admitted to the police that you'd driven home from the party. They consider that you were drunk, and it's just not good enough. You've been in the service 15 years.
John McCrae, the shy milkman, has surprised his instructors and himself by showing flashes of authority.
Coming, but I'm afraid that if this happens again, something will have to happen.
Right, good afternoon, A-Flight. As you know, as part of the course here at Octu, each flight has to do a project weekend. Now, our project...
Martin Oxborough, reckoned to be highly promising, has shown that he can command a group, but he's moody, sometimes depressed, and is thought to be missing his wife.
The weekend that we're going to do this is the 11th and 12th of July, 1980.
The final test is designed to stretch them to their limit, and it's tougher than usual this year. It's a bitterly cold December.
Well, six-day camp comes at the end of the course, and from the cadets' point of view, it's the last part of the course, and they tend to regard it as an examination.
The weather is the biggest enemy, really, because when you get this wet and this cold as it was last night, it's warm now, but cold as it was last night, you find yourself falling to sleep and trying to keep yourself awake was my worst problem last night, anyway. Several stints on guard duties and that sort of thing. If it's just two of you and you're walking around for sort of a couple of hours, you know, you find your eyelids beginning to drop a bit.
These are the orders for armed guards, right? And you will be armed. When you are posted, to make sure you understand your orders. You are not to quit your post.
It's a demanding scenario. It starts in the morning at about 6 and carries on until after midnight, with periods in between where they can rest. You tend to run down your batteries in that area. You become tired.
You are to challenge anyone who is not known to you or who is acting suspiciously. Do so in a firm, distinct voice, saying, "Halt, hands up." If he halts, you are to say, "Stand still and keep your hands up."
What we're actually looking for is common sense, self-confidence, a straightforward determination and drive. the ability to keep going when you get tired and when you're hungry and when it's raining and somebody comes along and says, I'm sorry, it's all changed, you've got to do this now, when you've just spent the last 2 hours doing exactly the opposite. In other words, we're trying to, not exactly trying to wear them down completely, but we're trying to lower their basic civilized built-up batteries. We're trying to lower them down to so that we get down to the real man, and he's not play-acting at all. He gives us a true insight into his character.
One called Hansen called out to some of the enemy forces and asked for their identification, whereupon they ran away giggling into the bush. And Hansen was most unimpressed. What are you going to do about it?
Well, certainly I should enforce, ensure that everybody who goes...
Alastair Stewart has been appointed camp commandant. He's under pressure now and not responding well. His disappointing performance will cost him his chance of the Sword of Honour.
They will on no account make any contact with them unless they have to defend themselves.
This camp, for many of them, is going to put much of their training into practice, into effect. We're going to see them displaying their leadership abilities and qualities. We're going to be seeing most of them displaying their officer qualities, you know, their sense of duty, their determination, just how loyal they can be to a leader that's not doing very well, things like that.
There you go. What are you trying to do?
We're going to see just how determined they are. You know, they are going to be very tired. They will be working long days. They're going to be doing rather a lot of thinking on their feet. We'll be seeing their attitudes to that.
I think once we get out and walk deeper, we'll be deep in the centre. But I don't think it's going to work.
There's been a valiant last-ditch effort from Rod Smart, but has it been enough? This was his flight commander's final report.
What's going in, is it?
In many respects, Smart is immature for his age. He still lacks sufficient flair, drive, and imagination to make the desired impact.
You think you'll put some water into it too?
Yeah, we need it to have at least, you know, some half water sunk inside, anyway, yeah. To stop it
get
from bobbing.
Ropes off anyway.
He has permitted his anxiety to succeed at Octu to impinge on everything he does. Consequently, he sometimes presents himself as a gauche, rash, and somewhat naive young man. Smart has failed to make sufficient progress in his leadership training and has yet to fulfill his leadership potential. He's inclined to lean too heavily on the stronger personalities within his team and often seeks reassurance prior to making his decisions. If the unexpected occurs, he's apt to become flustered and manifest a youthful impetuosity. Smart is still below the standard required for commissioning.
Rod Smart has failed. Others await their verdict. It'll be announced on the day they call Black Tuesday.